Welcome back to the Zep Pearl channel. This is VK, your host, and thought I'd do a video. I haven't done a video since, or a VC video since like May. I have a bunch of stuff that I've collected kind of over the summer, and I'll talk about some, I'll show some of the items here. But I also noticed today is my anniversary of my membership into the vinyl community on YouTube. So it was back in 2012, August 31st, that I did my first, my intro video, my first video of the VC, and so I thought, let's sit down and do a video, VK. It's good to see some familiar faces do videos. So that I know some of the old guard of the VCs coming around. That's great to see. So good to see that. I'm going to kick it off here with some 45s that I picked up, like I said, over the summer. The first one here is UFOs, Too Hot to Handle with the picture sleeve. On the Green Chrysalis label, but this was a red vinyl copy, which I thought, I didn't know it came out like that. But actually, that's the only time I've seen the 45, so, you know, I had to pick it up, man. It's UFO. Love UFO. And, you know, 45s. So, another one I picked up, one of my favorites, Bruce Springsteen songs, Hungry Heart. The picture sleeve's a little beat up, but, you know, like, you don't see them a lot. And this is just on the regular Columbia label. And then the last one I got to show for 45s at least is a favorite garage rock kind of band out of the 60s, I believe. The Standells, Dirty Water. You know, a song about Boston's dirty water. But it came with a label sleeve too, which is unusual to find sometimes. But love that song, and had to pick that up. And actually, it's like an upgrade copy that I had. I had the 45 before, it was all kind of scratchy. But that was really nice and clean. But let's get to the LPs here, man. The first one I picked up a while back, I might have ordered it off a website or something, is Mad Seasons with the Seattle Symphony. Two album set. I think they have like an overhead view there of the symphony and everything. This is called Sonic Evolution, recorded January 30th of 2015, so no Lane Staley on this. But it features Chris Cornell, Mike McCready, Matt Cameron, Duff McKagan, Jeff and Matt, Stone Gossard's on there, Sean Kinney, I think, yeah, Cornell does most of the vocals on this. But a real nice, really cool symphonic versions of some of the Mad Season songs, like River of Deceit's very cool. Reach Down, which actually is, well, that was a Temple of Dog song they do here, because obviously Cornell's singing. It comes with a nice little booklet here. It came with a booklet with pictures of all, you know, from the show. Nice inserts with information, pictures of it, Cornell, of course, and there's a little nice little custom labels there of the band. Really good. I like the sound quality. I thought it was really good. Didn't have any problems with that. You know, I'm not crazy about bands doing stuff with orchestras. You know, and yet I say that, and here I bought one, but so it's kind of iffy on getting this. But like Metallica's done one, and you know, it's all right and everything, but it's not like something I pick up to listen to a lot. This one I have, actually. This one I've listened to a few times already. You know, obviously it's been in my top spins for a while. All right, the next couple ones I'm going to show you are going to obviously feature some Led Zeppelin albums I picked up. In the middle of summer, the last week of June, first week of July, I took a huge monster family trip to Greece. It was like 18 of us, maybe even like 20 of us. The whole thing, man, the whole VK family back there, you know. So I had to do some record digging out there, so I finally found a little shop in Athens, came across it, and picked up some stuff. You know, I didn't really plan it out very well, you know, I guess. I didn't really think I was going to actually find a shop, and then I just had some time. I'm like, you know, screw it, I'm going to go find it. So I just kind of went there, just wanted to obviously grab some Zeppelin pressings and look for some other stuff. Oddly enough, I didn't get any Greek pressings of anything, which is kind of odd. I mean, you think I would have, right? I mean, I did see some. They had like a House of the Holy Greek pressing. But you know, the cover was kind of split and it didn't have the inner sleeve. And I was like, I'm going to pass on that one. But I found a store, Mr. Vinylos. Oh, Greek there. And I can't read the Greek as much as I used to when I was a kid, so I don't know what it exactly says with this comic, but they're hauling this guy off for something. So Mr. Vinylos, it was in this whole market area, you know, I went with my nephew Ryan, and we had a weasel back in the corner, and I finally found the shop. We're like all over on the GPS map thing, and we're like, where the heck is this place? We finally found it. He picked up some cool stuff. You know, I think he got some import stuff too. But I'll show you what I got here. Like I said, oddly enough, these aren't Greek pressings, but we'll start off with this one from 1981 pressing. This is a Mexican pressing of Led Zeppelin II. The different back cover, all in Spanish. The songs are in English, but they have descriptions underneath. And this is on red vinyl. That's the Atlantic label. You can check that. So kind of neat. I didn't realize a lot of them were on colored vinyl until a little later when I was opening them up, checking them out. But decent sounding pressing. You could obviously tell, you know, it's probably copied off of some other copy of something, but not too bad, listenable, definitely. So then right behind that was Led Zeppelin III, and this is a copy from Tel Aviv, and this had this was printed on there, which was the old hype sticker. And I'll show you this one. This is also on colored vinyl, red. Interesting little label here, kind of the color coordinates of the Atlantic logo and stuff. So I like that. I don't think I ever had an album from Tel Aviv, which is kind of neat, you know. And I get into the little different pressings, but these weren't. It's not a gatefold like the original either. But yeah, Tel Aviv right there. So that was cool. Now this one, I believe, was a German pressing, and actually a lot of maybe my European vinyl community friends out there. I have this sticker here on a couple of my another record or two, I could swear, that are all from Europe. What does that mean? What's that from? Is that some sort of a clearance thing? Is that a store maybe in somewhere that I don't know of? But this is Led Zeppelin IV, came with an inner sleeve. This is black. But yeah, this is a German pressing. You can see that Gemma on there. Again, sounds really, really nice. I always wonder what that sticker of the exclamation point is. Can you help me out there, brothers? What does that mean? Where's that from? All right, the last Led Zeppelin one I picked up in Greece was a copy of Led Zeppelin's Physical Graffiti. Now this one has a... different cover. There's the cutout of the windows aren't there. Doesn't say Physical Graffiti on the front. Has actually some of the pictures that were in the inner sleeve that slid through the thing. You know the story. On the back here, the hype sticker is actually printed on the back of the thing here, and then you can see it doesn't completely. Yeah, it does spell out Physical Graffiti, but you know how it used to be. That'd be the front. This was the back. So I don't know. Maybe you could tell it was kind of, the way it looks like it was like kind of pasted over with the logo there and everything. So, I remember the pressing. I think this is also a Spanish pressing. Let's see, this is also on colored vinyl. And, it's a Spanish pressing of Physical Graffiti. There's a brown Atlantic label on that one. So some nice little additions to the Led Zeppelin collection. You know, I gotta do that, because, you know, that's my band. All right, so moving on then. This one, it's a Deep Purple album I picked up. According to the hype sticker, it's a limited edition colored vinyl for only 2,000 copies. It's Deep Purple live in Newcastle, Australia, and in 2001. Just a brown paper cardboard cover. No expense was spared, I can tell, being such a limited edition. But sounds really good, though. Obviously, this is Steve Morse on guitar. Colored vinyl, there's a label for you. Doing a lot of the, trying to see, there's some later material on here covering a lot of the like stuff off the Bananas album and Perpendicular. But it's a set list. It's actually a three album set, inner sleeve and the inner gatefold. Spared no expense on putting this together, but sounds really good. Glad I picked it up. Now, is there really only 2,000 copies of this? I don't know. It's not numbered or anything, it's just what it says on the hype. But I had to pick it up. Live Purple, didn't have that. Era live, so that was cool. All right, now this one comes with a nice little story. This had to be, I can't even remember when it was now, but it's either July, early August or July maybe. I saw it was Buddy Guy's birthday coming up, and there was a birthday party going on for him at his Legends Club here in Chicago. So I figured, this is cool, $30, I'll go that, I thought kind of Buddy Guy was going to be there and play and everything, but it really was a couple blues bands there. His daughter's band was there and gone. As the time went from the time I bought my ticket, thinking, it's just going to be Buddy Guy playing, it'll be cool, to then information was coming through the show and stuff like that, and it was like, well, it doesn't seem like he's even going to be there. All these other bands, I don't see him on the bill. So I didn't know what to expect, but for $30, I'll go check it out on a Tuesday night. What else are you going to do? So it turns out he was there. He was there with all of his family. They passed around a little shot of whiskey or something like that, or some expensive cognac that he likes or something, to everybody in the place. And it was packed, a good, I don't know, what the place can hold, maybe 500 people or something like that. So they passed around those shots. I had a great little spot against a post right there, so nobody in front of me. I could see stuff great. So, and then in the end, the last band was up there, and Buddy Guy came up there and sang some songs with them, and he didn't play any guitar, oddly enough, but he just, I don't know if he expected to go up or not, but he got up to doing some songs, and it was great. It was cool to see, So what I thought he was doing, he left and kind of was going towards the door. I figured he's done. He's going to go home, get in a car, and take off, right? No, what does he do? He stops off at their merch desk, their stand that they have that's always there, where they sell t-shirts and his records. He sits down and he's going to sign stuff and take pictures. I was like, what? Cool. So I jumped in line real quick. I saw I was about 10 people in, so I didn't have to stay through the long wait. I didn't have nothing with me, man. So I bought the coolest record I could see that would look cool to be signed. So I picked up his Living Proof, and Buddy Guy signed it, man, right there. Buddy Guy, 2019, Living Proof album. I just picked something up that looked cool to sign. This came out in 2010, so it wasn't his latest album, but definitely, great blues stuff. This is a double album with three sides. The third side is sketched on black vinyl, but signed copy. And I have a picture of him, but unfortunately, with the way YouTube's changed things, I can't throw in a picture here, but you've probably seen it if you're one of my on my Facebook thing or something like that or whatever. But it was me and Buddy Guy just after he signed it, took a cool little picture, and it was very cool to everybody and very accommodating, not one of it was actually more of a staff was kind of hushing you along. He was just like, and then he'd break into conversation with you, and you're like, and their staff's like, all right, we gotta go. I was like, dude, he's talking. So that was pretty cool, man. This next one I haven't shown the stuff I got from Record Store Day back in, April? So this is one of them I did pick up on Record Store Day. It's not a Record Store Day title. I was out for a work thing out in Normal, Illinois, I went to this, I think it was like North Coast Records or something like that, North Records, and found this, kind of a bootleg or a pirate copy of Metallica, Metal Up Your Ass, which we all know was originally supposed to be, this is what the original first album was supposed to be like, but they changed it, they, you know, let the record company kind of twist their arm and change it to Kill 'Em All. But what this is a, it's the first album, but I don't, you know, it's a lot of the, either the demo tapes, yeah, it's a lot of the demo tapes, and then some of the, like the original version that's on Metal Massacre's on here of Hit the Lights. It's on the Music for Nations album. This was supposedly made in France, French pressing. But there's the back, the Cliff. You know, this is during, you know, the Mustang, before Kirk came in kind of years. It's on this like lime glow-in-the-dark vinyl with the Music for Nations label. And there's a little hint of like orange or brown splatter in there too. You can see it. You know, for what it is, it's really cool. You know, it's just something cool to have, outtakes or whatever. You know, kind of the before Kill 'Em All album and everything. So I was cool to pick it up. I never saw it before, and it was one of those things. You know, if I don't get this, I probably will never see it again. And so far, I haven't. Anybody out there, let me know if you have this or seen it. I don't know, you know, the year it was pressed, it's probably a newer copy just based on the colored vinyl and everything. It seems like, you know, everybody's doing colored vinyl now. But it's still cool, and the funny thing is too, you can tell that they used the imaging off of the old t-shirts that look like this too, because it's kind of fuzzy and stuff. It doesn't feel fuzzy, but I mean the print is kind of fuzzy where it looks like a t-shirt, and like they just took that print for the album. All right, moving on, and we're going to wrap it up here pretty soon. This is a local Chicago punk band of the late 80s, Big Black. Songs about fucking. So, hardcore kind of punk out of Chicago. This is on the Touch and Go label. It was based here in Chicago. Just hardcore, fresh punk stuff. I don't know, you know, the thing is, I don't know if this, I mean, just it just seems in too good of condition to be an original pressing, but then again, I can't find anything on here saying it's not, so, you know, other than I'll probably have to look up the Dead Wax numbers, which I haven't, I mean, who has time to do that, but there you go, Songs About Fucking by Big Black, local punk rock, came out in 87, and I remember seeing this all the time in the record shops. When I was going to school, going to college downtown, I remember guys bringing actually this in and some other punk stuff to do during our, I took a radio class, so you know, you're able to bring in some music, do like a little 15 minute show kind of thing. I remember guys bringing that in, and for whatever reason, I just never picked it up. Even though I heard it a bunch of times back then, you know, that along with, you know, other punk stuff, Naked Ray Gun and things like that. So it's cool to pick up. Here's a classic live album, The Who, Live at Leeds. Had to grab this. It had all the inside little features there, all the little goodies that come with it. You know, the photo that comes with it, the promotional, you know, mock-up photo with all the little invoices and notices. Promotional letters, and then the big, there's a poster, a marquee poster replica back here. That's in it. Show you that. All came with all these. I think there's a total of 11 items in this with all, you know, if you get that all. So, again, here's another thing that you just don't see all together, at least I don't. Usually you just see it with the record and maybe one or two things in there, and it's just a big folder, like, but, This is the whole deal, man. And it wasn't too bad. It's in really great shape considering, you know, some ring wear, which is expected. I mean, it is a brown plain cover. But this is on Decca, and I believe an original pressing of Live at Leeds from The Who. And kind of segue that, as you can notice the logo here on this one, you know, Live at Leeds inspired Pearl Jam to do Live at Soldier Field. This is another copy that I got of their Vault series. Not sure what vault number it is. Maybe 8 or maybe earlier than that. But this is a show I went to July 11th, 1995 at Soldier Field before they remodeled it. Pearl Jam used the stage, actual stage and lighting rigs were the Grateful Deads, who played there about the week before, so they just let them use the stage. This was broadcast on their pirate radio that they had also. But a great series. You can get these off their website, off of Pearl Jam website. They put them up very limited. I don't know if this one's up there, but there's a new one up there now. But this is a 3-album set, I believe. A 4-album set of the show. Like I said, I was there. I remember it. The odd thing about this is that they don't have the encores on here for whatever reason. I know even the CD version of this doesn't have the encores on it. And they did some cool encores. Some of them were like Let My Love Open the Door from Pete Townsend, Everyday People from Sly Stone. And I don't know why, and then of course Yellow Ledbetter in their songs. So I don't know why they didn't include it on here, or maybe they lost it'd be hard to say that they lost a copy of the recording or something, damaged it. Even if they couldn't get the rights to use those songs, they could at least put in their songs. It's kind of odd, but still, nice piece. Great sound quality on this. It's right off the broadcast, through the soundboard. So that's just awesome. I got a couple of those now, so I'm pretty happy to have them. And that's all I got, my friends. I got other stuff to show. We'll leave it for a later video. This one's already clocking in at 20 minutes, so I'll let you go. A few days ago, I saw Iron Maiden, man. They've been back on the road. So hopefully they're coming through your town. Those guys still got it, man. They put on a great show to about 15,000 people here out in the suburbs, Tinley Park. And they were just great. So glad to see them. I haven't seen them in about 9 years, so I was due for a Maiden show. Rumor is they might come back in the winter, so we'll see. Anyway, take care, everybody. Thanks for checking in.